spread the legs and coming forward too much, I want to stay outside him. Okay? So I'm just going to be... The thing is, he knows that that left hook is coming. Right? And what he's doing is, he want to step out it. Yeah? He want to go away. He doesn't want to stay here. So, he, I know that he's, I'm going to just... spin backwards. Doesn't need to be there. But when you go, go back again. Back again into where you are. You don't want to be here and stay in here for a weekend. You know what I mean? You want to start quick. Yeah? So, walk. If he's too far forward, then you get into a pose. Step into a walk. Right. And if he's hands in the face and the elbow, we're good to go with the elbow. It's legal. Life is beautiful. Just go. I don't think you do anything about it because you're gonna be there at some point, you know what I mean? If it's legal, but we need to find it. So one of these things was really cool off the hook shelf. Yeah? So I know that he's always gonna
take it.
I know that I'm moving it and he's just gonna go.
Could you do that to the body as well, maybe? Before you go.
Yeah.
Because his eyes might be up, expecting.
Yeah.
So if he's
going and this, I can change the angle of the gun.
See, level screen.
That's right.
So it could be really good. A bit more guns, these things again, just get these like sharp. Yeah. Just stay for them. Just more thigh, not just the knee. Landed the full thigh in. It's a very powerful, and if there's no headshots, there's no punishes or whatever on the head. There is, isn't there?
Aye, we're definitely punishes on the head, yeah.
I don't want to just you to focus on head.
Right, aye.
Bodies, you can knock him out with a good punish in the body shot. I want you to figure out that, because most the common mistakes I've seen is people going for the head a lot. He's covered. He's good to go.
Not
up really hurting. And you could have whacked.
Yeah.
One big shot in the air is.
Plus, the thing is, he needs to put his hands down and then you can get the head, so you're walking towards it. So
a good one's like the cross, because already loaded the shoulder.
Yeah.
And he's into the body.
Yes. I don't expect him done wrestling. And that should be a good favour on your part. That's an advantage. You've done jujitsu, you know basics about it. So if it comes to the fucking clinch, it's wrestle for the fucking clinch.
I think going into the fourth and the fifth, he'll be very tired. So he'll be, like how the boxer sometimes hold on, I think he'll be doing the same. He'll be trying to hold on for a rest.
Right, so your clinch has to be very powerful. Just go grab his fucking head and make sure you keep in your head, so always close it as close as possible to his head. Because I've seen this when you were doing this earlier, that's not true. You get a couple of knees and you won't like it. So one of you always the least foot to be reaching his groin guard. You feel his groin guard.
You can't help
it. You need to feel his groin guard. That's when you go.
Right.
Only when you want. You attack, you spread and go. If you don't, just keep going for it. Just keep feeling his groin guard and your thigh.
That makes it almost impossible for me to go near.
No chance.
I can't do it.
I'm closing that gap. He wants to knee me.
Right.
And he will just be looking. If I get against the rope or the fence, I'm good to go.
Yeah.
The pressure in. And I can just bomb back and boom and back again all day.
Yeah.
All day. Just more working, head control, whatever the gloves. Because it's more than the gloves as well. Yeah? But I just get used to that. Do that, a lot of that. So when you're here, to expect what will happen. If it's slippery, if it's wet, you make sure you're getting a good hold of his neck or the clinch. Yeah? So, how do you feel after that?
Feel good, yeah. Feel like I've learned that a lot.